Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you are new here. It is Wednesday, so that means it is another what I eat in a day to lose weight on WW. If you didn't know, I have switched over to the blue plan. I am also now eating a clean, whole food, organic, no fat free, limited sugar free diet. So what you see in today's what I eat in a day is going to be whole, substantial, delicious food. And tonight's dinner recipe, delicious. So if you want to see what I eat in a day to lose weight on the WW Blue Plan, stay tuned. On a run from my given disaster, speed away from the holy mind. I don't know who you are, I don't know what you've been through, why you got scars. Since you walked through the door, I've been trying to reach you, cause I feel you. What's the story to tell? What's the story behind the mountain you're trying to climb? Think I've heard it before in a movie line. So here is my breakfast for this morning. It's clean eating can be, you guys. I'm so excited. So I have 2 hard-boiled eggs, that's 0 points, with a little sprinkling of everything but the bagel seasoning. I sliced up an organic Gala apple, and then I'm going to be having an English muffin. I'm having this Food for Life. This is a sprouted Ezekiel 7-grain English muffin. These, you guys, are absolutely delicious. They're so hearty. They're heavy. They're just so hearty with nuts and good ingredients. It is 4 smart points for one of those English muffins. And then over here on my food scale, I weighed out 1 tablespoon of the Kirkland mixed nut butter. And I went ahead and put that right on my English muffin. So it is 4 smart points for the English muffin, 3 smart points for the mixed butter. So this is a 7 smart point breakfast. So I'm sitting here drinking some water, and look what came in the mail. So I'm super, super excited about these 2 new cookbooks. The first one is the Kristen Cavallari True Roots Cookbook. I actually heard about this on a clean eating YouTube channel, and this says a mindful kitchen with more than 100 recipes free of gluten, dairy, and refined sugar. Supposedly, this cookbook is supposed to be absolutely amazing. Lots of whole food ingredients. I'm so excited. So I'm going to be spending some time kind of digging through this and finding what recipes and how I can tweak them to be WW friendly. But I'm excited for this. This is, again, the Kristen Cavallari True Roots. And I did pick this up off of Amazon. I'll link both of these cookbooks in my Amazon store down in the description box for you guys. And I got this Instant Loss Eat Real Lose Weight. And this girl lost 125 pounds. Look at that. And she's sharing with us some of the recipes that she used. Her name is Brittany, and how she lost weight. So I'm excited for this one too. It looks like it's going to be a lot of Instant Pot recipes, which I was having a hard time finding Instant Pot recipes that were whole foods. So I am very excited for this. So you guys will be seeing recipes coming down from both of these cookbooks. So if you're interested, I'll link these down below for you guys. Lulu, did you make a nest? Did you? My pillows were right where you're laying. Yeah, like daddy's are here, and right where you are were mine. Yeah, so you made a nest. So this is my lunch for today. I have a water sitting over there too. So what I have here is I have 6 of my meatballs that I prepped in meal prep that was posted on Monday. I will definitely link that video down below for you guys. These are a Parmesan sun-dried tomato. They are so good. Made with organic grass-fed beef, makes a huge difference. You could have 4 of these meatballs for 4 smart points, or 6 of these meatballs for 6 smart points. So basically they end up being about a smart point a piece. So I'm going to have 6 of them for 6 points. And then I have 1/4 cup of quinoa, also prepped in Monday's meal prep. I made it with chicken broth, so I have no butter. I don't have anything on this other than salt and pepper. And 1/4 cup of quinoa is 2 smart points. And then I have 1/2 cup here of organic corn. No butter, just some salt and pepper. It's sweet enough. It doesn't need the butter. And I don't want to spend the points if I don't have to. So this is 6 smart points for my meatballs, 2 for my quinoa. So this is an 8 smart point lunch. So I just finished lunch and I'm getting ready to head out to show a client some properties. I'm gonna be gone the rest of the afternoon, probably till dinner or even past. So I'm gonna pack some snacks.
some good clean eating snacks to make sure that I have food available if I get hungry. But I don't know if you guys noticed, but I did not eat my Built Bar between breakfast and lunch because I was not hungry. And I'm still wasn't even that hungry when I ate lunch. So I don't know if I'll even eat these snacks, but I'll definitely let you guys know when I go to edit this video. But I'm gonna bring some strawberries that I had cut up earlier for the week, some carrots. And then I have 1 ounce of these, the Good Beans sea salt chickpeas. You guys, these are great. Great ingredients, they're organic. There's nothing in them, literally, except for chickpeas, organic oil blend of sunflower, safflower, and red palm oil, which is actually a really good oil, and sea salt. The only bad thing about the oils is they're not expeller pressed, but they're still really good oils. So 1 ounce of that, or this whole little bag right here, is 3 smart points. And that's going to be 3 smart points on all plans. And then I am going to bring my Built Bar because I'm probably gonna want something sweet this afternoon. So I'm gonna take this with me. This is the peanut butter. Actually, my favorite Built Bar, right along with the Mint Brownie Delight and the Coconut Almond. I love the peanut butter. This particular one is 4 smart points, where most of the other Built Bars are 3, but that is because it is made with organic peanut butter and it has little chunks of peanuts in it. So look at these macros, 170 calories, 20 grams of protein. So it keeps you super full, 7 fiber, 7 fat, and only 3 sugar. These are so good. And again, I'm probably gonna want something sweet. They have pretty darn good ingredients for protein bars. There are 2 ingredients that I'm not like super excited about, but luckily those 2 ingredients are the very last, or one of the last 2, and that's maltodextrin and natural flavor. You never wanna see natural flavor in food, it's artificial flavor. And maltodextrin is not the best sugar alternative. It does spike your blood sugar. Luckily, they are towards the end of the ingredient list, so I'm okay with my Built Bars. I love them. Again, 4 smart points for this. My code here on the screen will get you 10% off and free shipping. You guys, pick up Built Bars. They are a game changer, lifesaver on WW. 3 smart points for the chickpeas, 0 and 0. So this is 7 smart points worth of snacks if I get hungry. But let's pack these up, get some water, and get on the road. What's it time for? What's it time for? Oh, I know what it's time for. It's treat time. Good boy. And for you, baby, here you go. Good job, guys. Hey, guys, I am in the car, headed out to show some clients some properties. I'll see if I can get a few little clips of the homes that we're going to see. But it is kind of crummy weather and we're going out into basically the country. So I will do my best to get some clips for you, but you saw my snacks that I packed. So I am set. I'm sure that we'll have to stop and eat somewhere. And by me having the snacks, that takes that out of the picture for me. So we shall see what the day brings us and if my clients can find their perfect home. There is so much snow up at this property I'm going to show. Granted, it is kind of up in the country, but we have no snow at all. And actually, I just got off of the road and the road was covered in snow. So now it isn't as bad, but holy moly, it's beautiful up here, but there is a ton of snow still. 'Cause I feel you. What's the story to tell? What's the story behind the mountain you're trying to climb? Think I've heard it before in a movie. Here's our final house. This is massive 5,000 square foot stucco house in this beautiful property on 20 acres. Look at this view. I mean, this is a $1 million view. So this is my final house for today. I am headed home. In this box, my friends, is something I'm so excited for. Ta-da! My healthy eating all the time and Go Bar order. So I just put this order in. She was having a great special over Valentine's Day. So I picked up my very, very favorite bars, especially now that I am eating as clean and whole foods as possible. These are so great. This is my favorite, the natural peanut butter oat bar. There are your ingredients. They are so good. There is nothing at all questionable. The macros are amazing. I count these bars as 6 smart points. So you can see I ordered a ton of the chocolate and then she sent me some, which was really sweet too. But then I also ordered, oh, let's dig. Oh, way at the bottom, you can see I really stocked up. But I also ordered my second favorite, which is the natural peanut butter oat bar. This is the one that has like the cranberries in there. And again, stellar ingredients, whole food, clean ingredients, great macros, 6 smart points. And then she sent me a couple I have not tried, so I'm pretty excited. This is the natural peanut butter low carb chia protein bar. So this one has some chia seeds in it. And then she also sent me this one. This is the natural peanut butter low carb protein bar, apple and cinnamon. That sounds really, really, really delicious. So look at that, yum. So I'm glad to be stocked up on these. These are great meal replacements on the go. I eat it every Friday after Weight Watchers, or actually after Jazzercise. This is my breakfast because I'm always editing my video and getting it uploaded. So I'm stocked for a while. Thank you, Healthy Eating. So if you guys are interested, I do have 12% off. The code is here on the screen. It's not an affiliate link. I don't receive anything. But I literally stand behind this company 1,000,000%. And now that I, again, am in this clean eating, I'll be eating a lot of these bars. They are so incredibly delicious. For dinner tonight, I'm going to be making a baked gnocchi with marinara sauce. I'm gonna pair that with some chicken and some veggies. So let me show you what you're going to need for tonight's dinner. You'll need an 8x8 greased casserole dish, whatever kind of gnocchi or potato gnocchi you wanna use. This is the Trader Joe's, has good ingredients, so I picked that up. Of course, some salt and pepper, Parmesan cheese, ricotta cheese. You can use low fat. I will give you the smart points for both with the regular ricotta and the low fat. I chose the regular because it didn't have any weird ingredients. It actually has just whole ingredients in it. And then you'll need some 0 point skinny-ish dish crockpot marinara. And then I'm gonna be pairing that with some of this organic multicolor cauliflower blend. We're just gonna throw this in the microwave and warm it up. And then I'm going to try the Caulie Power New Chick on the Block chicken tenders. I'm really excited to try these. Gluten-free, no antibiotic chicken, cage-free chicken, and no artificial ingredients. So I'm going to be giving these a try. So let's get started on our gnocchi. So the first thing we're gonna do is get our water coming to a boil. You're gonna go ahead and add in your package of gnocchi because we want to boil this until soft. Then we're gonna go ahead and turn our oven on and get our chicken in. So we're ready to pop in the chicken. Here are my 2 Caulie Power New Chick on the Block. So I'll definitely be able to let you guys know how these are. And then I just have some Tyson breaded chicken here for my husband. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop these in the oven at the same temperature, 425, that we're gonna put our baked gnocchi with ricotta in. So I boiled my gnocchi and then rinsed and drained it. Put it here in my greased dish. To that, I'm just going to add just a little bit of salt and pepper over the top of the gnocchi. And then we're gonna add the ricotta, marinara, and top it with some of the Parmesan cheese. So first we'll start with the ricotta. So you're just gonna go ahead and measure out. I did 3/4 cup of the ricotta cheese, and I'm just going to drop it on top of the gnocchi and just kind of spread it out as I go. We wanna make sure that we have a little bit of the ricotta cheese on all the pieces of gnocchi. Looking good. So next we're gonna go ahead and add our marinara. So again, this is the 0 point marinara. This is about 1/2 cup. And I'm just going to scoop it right on top of the gnocchi, just like I did with the ricotta cheese. Make sure it gets nice and spread out and all of the gnocchi is covered. And last but not least, we're gonna go ahead and top it with 1/4 cup of the Parmesan cheese. This is not reduced fat or anything, it's just regular Parmesan cheese. And then we are going to get this in the oven at 425 with our chicken.
Way behind the mountain you're trying to climb. Think I've heard it before in a movie line. We can ride our own end in the sky.
So the baked gnocchi is out of the oven. I'm gonna let it rest for just a couple of minutes. This pan makes only 4 servings, so we'll cut this up, I'll plate it up, and I'll be back to show you all the smart points. And then here are my new Chick on the Block chicken strips, and then regular ones for my husband. And I'm actually going to put the French's honey mustard on mine. The ingredients in this are not bad at all. I was nervous, hoping that it wouldn't be too terrible, and it's not. So definitely something I can still eat. So I'm gonna put just 0 points worth, so just a very small amount on my chicken, and the cauliflower is in the microwave. So I'll be back to show you my dinner and give you the smart points. Here is my dinner for tonight. So I have some of the multicolored cauliflower. All I did is add just the tiniest bit of salt and pepper to it, so that is 0. I have two of the cauliflower new chick on the block chickens. These are one smart point a piece, and that doesn't change the more you have, so no weird Weight Watchers math with that. So that's 2 points. And then I have 1/4 of the baked ricotta gnocchi with marinara, and that is going to be 7 smart points using the full fat ricotta cheese. So my dinner is a total of 9 smart points. So for dessert tonight, I'm going to have my coconut crispy rollers from Costco. These are delicious. They're organic. They have amazing, amazing ingredients in them. Nothing artificial whatsoever. I mean, absolutely perfect ingredients in these, and they really truly are so delicious. So I am going to have 5 of those, and 5 of those is 3 smart points. So that's going to finish out my night, and I actually have 2 points left over. So this is my dessert for tonight. Thank you for joining me on another What I Eat Wednesday. I hope you got some great ideas on some whole delicious organic foods that you can incorporate into your day. It's crazy that we can eat these full fat, delicious, healthy foods and stay well within our smart points. I was so satisfied and full today. It's a feeling I haven't had in a long time. By eliminating processed foods, you just feel so much better. Check out the recipe down in the description box for tonight's dinner. It was delicious, as well as all of the links, discount codes that I can save you some money on. And of course, down in the description box is the link that will take you directly to my Facebook group. So head on over and join us there. It's a great place to come for support, ideas, recipes, and of course, just a lot of fun. So head on over and join us there. If you're new, welcome, welcome. I'm excited to share with you how you can incorporate a whole foods diet with minimal processed foods and still stay well within your WW smart points. So thank you guys for stopping over and watching my video. Make sure you're subscribed and your bell notification is turned on so you don't miss a single video. Thumbs up if you love what I eat in a day and love this new whole foods approach. And comment down below, let me know what was your favorite part of today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!